What up, guys?
I keep forgetting to record when I'm doing shit, but right now I'm just taking off the oil pressure switch because I'm gonna replace it because I gotta check in LA for it. To put in the car in limp mode, so hopefully that fixes it. And then, so I gotta go to the store and grab that. And then once I get back, I'll swap that out. And then I'll probably jack up the rear of the car so that I can maybe bolt the exhaust back up where it unbolted itself. And I also got, 2 seconds. I got a muffler tip. It's mad long. I'm not gonna have it stick out that far. And the ultra quiet vibrant resonator. So that I can have like a full exhaust again. So I'm gonna have to get a little bit of fabrication done to it for it to work, but oh, you have it stick out like that. Let me grab like a jack stand or a piece of wood for the tip to sit on so I can see how it's gonna look. Maybe even have it like this, like flush. But I don't know, I feel like sticking out a tiny bit looks good. Like how I had it in the first couple like little B-roll shots. Like that, maybe. Don't look terrible. But like obviously I'm not about to have it out like that. That's just gonna look stupid as fuck in my opinion. But if I do like that, just a little bit. I don't think it looks bad. I think it looks better than being flush, to be honest. But I don't know. We'll see. Hopefully it sounds pretty similar to what the NVIDIA sounded like. I mean, it's definitely going to be louder, I'm thinking, because this is the ultra quiet resonator compared to the NVIDIA Q300 muffler. So, I mean, it's a pretty big difference, but fuck it, I can't run that shit, so I'm gonna have to do what I gotta do. Besides that, though, I think I'm gonna just make this like a, basically like what's done to the car type of video. So, yeah. So, basically, when I first got it, it was dark gray. I'll put up a picture or a video of it. Already had the FD trunk, but it was carbon. I traded for a CSX trunk. Ended up getting clear tails. One of the first things I did was put on the FD front, so fenders, lights, bumper, lip, hood, but I'm not running it because this car don't need a hood. And then once I had the front end on, I had it painted Midori Green Pearl from the EK hatch. Been through a couple sets of wheels. Currently on Workmeister S1 three piece, 18 by 9.5, -22 offset. This is my fitment with no spacers. I might end up, I seen someone, I don't know him by name, but on IG, he's Trap and Civic. He has his rear trailing arm.
His rear trailing arm, like from right there, extended.
To get more camber, like bring the wheel out more from the bottom. So I think I'm gonna end up doing that because I want to match the rear camber to the front. 22 in the front, 18 in the rear. Custom headlights. They have halos, switchback. It's full bolt-ons. A lot of chrome powder coat. Mugen oil cap. Full Downstar hardware. Dress up kit. The bay is tucked and shaved. Even the radiator support shaved. DC5 Creations AC tuck kit. So goes out into the wheel well and then comes up here, and then they're right here. Go into the compressor, and then the other one right there going down to the condenser. Also have the DC5 Creations ABS delete. If you notice, I don't got it over here, the ABS. So that proportion valve gets rid of the ABS, and then it just runs stainless lines to the master and to the front calipers. So yeah. Has port mount, K-tune shift cables. Transmission was completely rebuilt with Synchrotech. Don't look at none of that shit. This shit is ugly as fuck. Synchrotech 1-4 carbon synchros. Brand new Exedi stage 1. Oh, and since I said it's full bolt-ons, I might as well go over it. Hybrid intake that I modified with just a Vibrant coupler so that it's not in the wheel well, because it kept getting eaten at by the tire. But I plan on getting a custom one made, like a billet one that goes down. Not in the wheel well though, like right here pretty much. I also gotta get like a custom coolant overflow tank made, because right now I just got a zip tied right there. I mean, no one sees it, but still, I know it's like that, so I wanna change it. Ported RBC J37 throttle body with the spacer and adapter. I mean, RDX 410 cc injectors, hybrid fuel rail, Skunk 2 alpha header. It was a full NVIDIA Q300 exhaust, like I said, but I can't run the muffler, so I got a resonator in the muffler. I already said that. I'm probably missing some things, but I feel like that's pretty much it for performance wise shit. Inside, let me grab my light. Alright, so I have hybrid racing short shifter that I got powder coated chrome. Acuity shift knob. Sony double din. I got PRV door speakers all around, wired to a Teramps 800x4. I got Braum bucket seats. I did the headliner and the sunroof slider myself. I want to redo the sunroof, though. I liked it at first, but I think I want to just do it all black. I have floor mats, they're just not in, so don't mind that. Type R overlay. I got the black one. Kind of wish I got the white one. It's not like it's real, but I like it better than the SI. I don't care. Also, I was fucking with the needle when I took it apart, like going like, whoa, like a dumbass. And I think I fucked it up. Probably not for good. Like, I could probably put it back. So, yeah. Now when I start the car, it shows it idling at like 1K instead of 2K. And then when it drops down to being warmed up, it's at zero. It's kind of funny. Whatever. I'll fix it eventually. Not really worried about it. I got the center console. It's just not in here. I'll put it back in eventually. There's my fuse box and ECU. Flash Pro. I definitely gotta clean this shit up some more. FD2. Type R hazard button. I haven't really showed the gas yet, so yeah, basically it works, so I'm gonna leave it like that for now. Yeah, I think I want to go a little lower in the future, so I might have to cut up the wheel well, but we'll see. I'm definitely going lower in the front. Probably just go until I have tiniest bit of room to the wheel arch, but which is close to an inch, probably like 3/4 of an inch I have to go lower. And then this is my trunk setup. It's nothing crazy, it's just the shock towers right there. You can't see the filler neck because I got the carpet in. 212 audio pipe quad stacks. Yeah, quad stacks. Batteries in the trunk. DC5 Creations billet battery tray. All these grounds I made myself. That shit goes right to the alternator and the starter in the front. It's definitely not the cleanest shit, but whatever. And then like for looks, I got OEM HFP rear lip, Type R style side skirts, chrome door handles, hybrid mirrors, clear side markers. I don't know exactly what this is called. This badge, I think it's from like a Honda, some type of motorcycle or some shit, or like a N600, or I don't even know what the fuck it's called. But I think I'm gonna swap it out for a gold one. This one's chrome. I think I'm gonna swap it out for a gold one. But OEM window visors, HIC roof visor, or rear window visor, whatever you want to call it. This is the Mugen style front lip. Suspension wise, it's BC Extreme Lows on 40K Swift Springs. That's how I ordered them. So the struts are valved for 40K springs. Low life top hats. Had to cut the shock tower a little bit for to max this for wheel clearance. Down there is the low life ball joint extension. My coils are slotted up there.
the slot at the moment for this camber. I got brackets that I made myself. Pink caliper, stainless braided brake lines, tie rod extension.
And yeah, that's pretty much it. I don't want to make this video too long, so I think I'm going to just end it there. I'll probably just upload this so I can push some more content out. And then I'll make another video once the exhaust is all together. So, if you made it to the end of the video, thank you for watching. Make sure to leave a like, comment, subscribe. More videos to come.
Yeah, I don't be giving no fucks. I don't know what you call it, I don't be giving a fuck. I say whatever I want, yeah. I do whatever I want. I'm counting up money for fun. You know, popping these purchases for fun.